Hi everyone, welcome to Mathematically Inclined. Before we proceed with the video, have a look at the kind of questions we are going to discuss today. Please note, all these have appeared in JEE, NDA, CETs and many more competitive exams. Have a look. Now, the secret behind these questions is, each time you have to get the factors or divisors of any number, the first step is always its prime factorization. At this level, we all know how to prime factorize, so I take it for granted. Once you have prime factorized the number, trust me, it doesn't take more than 2 seconds to get your answer. You want to know the secret? Let the magic begin. So once I have prime factorized this number, the answer to this one should be, that's it. It is as simple as that. Suppose we are given a certain number of things where P, Q, R and S, these are alike. That means they are similar or identical, and the remaining N, R may be different. All you need to do is add 1 to the identical one. That means if there are P things which are identical, it's P plus 1, Q plus 1, R plus 1, S plus 1, so on and so forth. And the last one, that means these remaining n terms, they're all single each. So if they are single each, I add 1 to each of them. So suppose my T is occurring only once, my U is occurring only once. So I keep adding 1 to each of them, and whatever are the number of times, it becomes 1 plus 1 into 1 plus 1 into, so 2 into 2 this way. It will be 2 raised to power n. That's it. That's your answer. So if I show you how did I apply this formula in this one, it's quite self-explanatory. The moment I prime factorized it, we ended up getting the numbers to be 3, 1, 2, 1. So this basically means 2 is occurring thrice, 5 is occurring twice, and then 3 and 7 are occurring only once. So that means it is 3 plus 1, which is 4, into 2, 8, into 3, 24, into 2, which is 48. That's it. That was our answer. Now, have a look at the second question. It says, find the proper divisors or factors of the number 2520. Now, if you focus, there is a new word here which says proper. But even for that, first we need to get total. So, once again, I have already prime factorized the number. Having done that, you know the answer by this formula would be, so for the total divisors, it would be 3 plus 1, that's 4. 2 plus 1, that's 3, and then these will be 2 and 2. So that means I get the answer to be 48 one more time. However, we all know by proper divisors, we mean apart from the number itself and 1. So if I delete, because 1 will be the factor of anything and 48 is also a factor of itself. So the number of proper divisors would be 48 minus 2, which is 46. Bingo. If you look at questions 3 and 4, now they appear to be quite similar because we are asking for proper divisors of the number 5040 in both the cases. However, there is a secret word which is hidden behind both of them. The first one talks of even proper divisors and the second one talks of odd proper divisors. What do we do with this? Of course, the first step happens to be prime factorization. After that, please take a screenshot of this or note down what you are going to do in the case of even and in the case of odd. Alright, so as I have very clearly given you the steps, which will still ensure you get the answer in 2 seconds. So if you have to get even divisors, then you retain the number you want. For instance, if I'm looking for an even divisor over here, we know it is going to end with at least 1, 2. So, you retain the number you want. That means you retain the power of this number and let it be 4 and increase the rest powers and increase the rest of the powers by 1. So if it is 2, it changes to 3. These two are already 1, 1, so they change to 2 and 2. Which gives us the answer 12 into 4, one more time 48. However, you will stop here if the question was only getting the even divisors. However, here the question says getting even proper divisors. Now, ideally, proper means you're going to delete the number itself and 1. But if you actually logically think about it, 1 is an odd number. So it would not occur over here. So the only deleting part you are doing is for the number itself. So 48 minus 1, that means 47 is the answer. So 47 even proper divisors are there for the number 5040. Now talking about the fourth question, which said find the number of odd proper divisors. Once again, after prime factorization, you increase the number, by which I mean the number of the power, by 1, which you want. So if I'm looking for an odd divisor of the number 5040, it is obvious it is going to end with 3, 5 or 7 at least. Then only it's going to be an odd divisor. Okay, so I increase the number by 1. So if this is 2, I make it 3. If this is 1 and 1, I make it 2 and 2. And what do you do about the term which is remaining? No, you don't copy it down as it is. You don't retain it. What you do is you just simply forget about it. So this is the only answer, and the answer becomes 12. However, the question said proper. So if we were looking at total divisors, then this is the answer. But for the proper divisors or proper odd divisors. Now again, for proper, we will delete 1 and the number itself. But if you actually look at the original number, it is even number by default. So 5040, that means cannot be a factor amongst these. So the only deletion you do is 1 time, and thus the proper odd divisors for the given number are 11. If you wish to see more and more super shortcuts on permutations and combinations, make sure to comment that in the section below. And also don't forget to check out the playlist on permutations and combinations shortcuts, the link to which is in the description box. You can get the same by clicking at the I button. Let's take one more question of this type. So suppose the number is 540. I've already done the prime factorization for it. Let's say we have to get odd number of divisors. So for that, you know if you want the number to be odd, it is going to end in 3 or 5. So these are the numbers we want to retain. So we increase the power by 1. So this is 4 into 2, and we forget about the remaining. So the answer is simply 8. And please see, this time I just said find the total number of odd divisors. There's no word like a proper. So 8 is the answer. Likewise, if I have to get even divisors for this, even says retain the number you want. Now, obviously, if you want even divisors, you want them to end with at least a 2. So you retain that power, and for the remaining, you increase the powers by 1. So this is going to become 4, and this one is going to become 2. So the answer this time is 16. Wasn't this easy? It's time for your DIY or do-it-yourself question. Yes, it says find the total number of proper divisors or the factors for the given number, which is 75,600. So the moment you prime factorize, you reach the answer in quick 2 seconds. I am sure you enjoyed this video. If yes, then make sure to give it a big thumbs up. Share it with all the people around you. Comment in the section below. And if you haven't done that so far, make sure to subscribe to my channel. Also, do not forget to check out the various playlists on my channel, which you can find under the playlist section, under the home section, and also in the description box of every video. I will see you with a new exciting video real soon. Until then, bye-bye.